Arise, O children of the Most High God, and take your place. This is Ken Cooper. Get ready, because Pastor Glenn Curry is going to get us energized on the living word from our great God.
Welcome to today's broadcast, you mighty earth-shaking champion. I'm Pastor Glenn Curry, speaking blessings, increase, power, might, dominion to you in the mighty name of Jesus. It's Miracle Monday. And listen, when you cook something to eat for your family, do the angels do the dishes and the cleanup for you? No. When you go out in the garage, men, and you have to cut a piece of lumber or you got to work on your car, when you're done, there's still cleanup to do. Well, I've been telling you a lot of things, and I have a little bit of cleanup to do. A few weeks ago, I was telling you about Satan, who's called the God of this world, 2 Corinthians 4:4. And then he's called that the whole world lies, I'm going to really paraphrase it, it's from 1 John, it says the whole world lies outstretched comfortably in the lap of the wicked one. And I will give you the verse in tomorrow or a couple days, okay? But we're talking about the devil, and we saw in the book of the Revelation, chapter 12, verse 7, and there was war in heaven, and Michael and his angels fought against the dragon, that's who we call Satan, and the dragon fought against his angels and prevailed not. Neither was there any place found anymore for him in heaven. Remember, we looked at Ezekiel 28 and Isaiah 14. Those are the two chapters that give us insight to what Lucifer was doing before he got kicked out of heaven. And you know from our teaching and from the straight out from the Bible that he was God's, I'm going to call it merchandise distribution manager. Okay? That's what Lucifer did for God, and he was stealing from God. And we covered that. And then in verse 9, it says, and the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil. So the dragon is also called the old serpent, and he's called the devil. And here it says, and Satan. Let me just read verse 9 and not try to talk about it, okay? And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceives the whole world. Now, we're part, as Christians, of the whole world. That tells us that even Christians can be deceived. And so it's very important that you get the correct word of God. I mean, it's amazing to me. Like on YouTube, I'm doing these things called shorts, and sometimes I'm teaching for 10 minutes, 5 minutes, sometimes they're just 1 minute, and I get comments. And so many people are rebuking me, telling me that you got to jump through all these hoops and change your behavior so much for God to love you and for you to get blessed. They don't know that the Bible says, and I don't have the word in front of me, I'm just talking off the top of my head and out of my heart. It says that the law and the prophets are fulfilled when you walk in faith and you walk in love. So love and faith fulfills the law, okay? So anyway, the old devil was cast out down to the earth and his angels. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now is come salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ. And the accuser of our brethren, that's another name for Satan, was cast down, which accuses them day and night. Now, verse 11 is a big verse for us. And they, that means we, overcame him, that is the dragon and the serpent and the devil and Satan, same person, by the blood of the Lamb. And there's nothing we can do about the blood of the Lamb. That's already been poured out for us. That means the blood of Jesus. You either accept that or reject it. That's all you can do with the blood of the Lamb. But the next part, we have a part to play to overcome the devil. And it says, and by the word of their testimony, and they love not their lives unto death, therefore rejoice, you heavens, and all that dwell therein. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil has come down unto you having great wrath, because he knows his time is short. But I read that passage of scripture so many times myself, but I opened it in my iPad where I have my Strong's Concordance, and we overcome the devil by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. The word of our testimony is not, well, I used to be a drug addict, and I used to be an alcoholic, and I used to be a womanizer, and then I got saved. That's a testimony. But that's not the word of your testimony. The word of your testimony, I've been telling you, is putting the word of God or statements that are in line with the word of God in your daily conversations, okay? When people say, man, America's really going down, everything sucks, the economy's bad, I don't know if I can keep up, you're not going to say, well, my God shall supply all my need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. That's what you mean. But you just say something like, if you don't want to say the scripture to this person, because maybe you think they'll be offended or they'll think you're a religious fanatic or whatever, you just say, well, I'm just believing my every need is met. At least you're speaking in line with the word of God. If you can't speak the word, speak in line with the word of God. That's the word of your testimony. That's how we overcome the devil. But in my Strong's Concordance, King James, I touch the word testimony. I have that in front of me right now. I'm going to touch it again. The word of our testimony, we overcome the devil. And Strong's Concordance, the very first thing it says is evidence given. The evidence given. Wow, that spoke to me so strong. What is our evidence? Our evidence is the word of God. And so we overcome the devil with the word of our God. We overcome the devil with our, what did I say it was? Our testimony, the word of our testimony. We overcome the devil with the evidence given. Okay, because it says testimony, the evidence given. So when you put your finger on a verse that says, my God shall supply all my need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus, that is the evidence given. When you say 1 Peter 2:20, that would be Philippians 4:19. When you put your finger on 1 Peter 2:24 and say, by his stripes I was healed, that's evidence given. God's word is the evidence. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. So the word of God is the evidence that you got to use to win in life. Amen. So I wanted to get that behind me for sure. Okay. And then the other thing I wanted to get behind me, I've been telling you about the Old Testament sacrifices and how they appointed Jesus. In John 5:46, Jesus told the people that were there then, had you believed Moses, you would believe me, for he wrote of me. I just felt like, I don't know if I remembered telling you that before. And then we've been talking about being born again. And so what we're really saying is that you've been fathered by God. And when you get that aha moment that you've been fathered by God, you have a relationship with God. He's your heavenly father, your spiritual father. But you also have fellowship with him. You can have relationship with a person. This guy's my dad. This guy's my uncle. But maybe you haven't seen them for years. Maybe you don't call them. Maybe you avoid them, right? And so you can have a relationship, but not fellowship. But I want you to know you have relationship, and fellowship should be just norm for you, fellowshipping with God. 1 Peter 1:3, I want to give you the verses so that you know that you're fathered by God. So, and I believe that's going to take care of any bad self-image you have, any failure in the past that is an anchor to you. I believe that this is going to help you help your self-image big time. 1 Peter 1:3, King James. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy has begotten us. That word begotten means fathered us again unto a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ. 1 Peter 1:23, being born again, fathered by God, being a son or daughter of God, being born again, not of corruptible seed, but incorruptible by the word of God, which lives and abides forever. James 1, of his own will, he begat us. He fathered us by the word of truth, that we should be the first fruits of his creation. Of his own will, he begat us. That means of his own will, he fathered us. You're not a oops. You're not an accident. God wanted you, so he fathered you. Okay? He wanted a family, so he fathered you. 1 John 2:9. Now, John really wants you to know this because he talks about it many times. John 2:29. If you know that God is righteous, you know that everyone that does righteous or acts like him is born of him, has been fathered by God. 3:9. 1 John, I'm going to stay there. Whosoever is born of God, that means fathered by God, does not practice sin, for his seed remains in him, and he doesn't sin because he's been born of God. He doesn't practice sin because he's been born of God or fathered by God. That was not King James. Beloved, let us love one another, for love, that's 4:7, 1 John 4:7. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone that loves is born of God. If you're walking in love, it's obvious that you're fathered by God and know God. 1 John 5:1, I think I got to jump ahead. I have too many verses for you here, and I don't want to just spend the whole broadcast. It looks like I'm doing it, just cleaning up my messes that I've made. Whosoever believes that Jesus is the Christ is born of God. If you believe in Jesus, that he's the Christ, he's the Messiah, he's our deliverer, he's the sent one by God, then you're born of God, are fathered by God. And everyone that loves him that begat was fathered by God. Loves him that is begotten was born of God. Let me just read the Revelation 1, 5 and 6. It says, from Jesus Christ, who is the faith. I'm jumping ahead. There's more verses in 1 John about us being fathered by God, and I'm almost out of time. Darn, I don't know if I could do this. And from Jesus Christ, who is a faithful witness, the first begotten of the dead, the first to be born again person, the prince of the kings of the earth, who loved us and washed us in his from sin in his own blood and made us kings and priests unto our God, and we shall rule forever with him forever. I had to paraphrase it. I didn't do it exactly right. I love you. Have a great, great day.
Thank you, Pastor Glenn. God's mighty word is building you up and giving you your inheritance. So keep building your faith and keep going strong with God. Be sure to tell your friends and family about this edifying broadcast. This broadcast is sponsored by Pillars of Faith and you, our faithful listening audience.